Judge Mukasey's nomination thrust the issue of waterboarding and torture into the spotlight. In her latest book, The Shock Doctrine, award-winning author Naomi Klein has a chapter all about the history of torture. She joins me now in the Firehouse studio. Welcome to Democracy Now, Naomi.
Thank you, Amy. Good to be with you again.
Respond to what you've just heard.
Well, I think that was an absolutely shocking display, and I think what's most shocking about it is this idea that this is somehow a question of good government and this, the torture question can be belittled. I mean, what we just saw was lawmakers knowingly voting in favor of someone who has said that one of the classic modern torture techniques, I mean, the classic torture techniques of the French in Algeria, for instance, were simulated drowning, electroshock, and rape. These are the three main tools of contemporary torture. And this is a man who has said to the world that one of those key techniques, simulated drowning, water torture, is not illegal. So with that knowledge, he was just endorsed. And to elevate a man who has said this to the highest legal office in the country, I think just puts every one of those lawmakers, but particularly the Democrats who voted for him, into bold new territory. They've just crossed a line because they can no longer pin this on Bush. They can no longer claim ignorance. Anyone who faces these techniques in the future, they will be complicit in those war crimes, in those crimes against humanity. Everybody who voted for this man.
It's interesting, you just heard Charles Schumer, the New York Democrat, saying we can just pass a law against waterboarding. Of course, Ted Kennedy said we have passed laws against torture. But that idea of passing a law, but that law also has to be signed by President Bush. And whether or not he signs it, if he does sign it, he can do what he has done more than 1,000 times, which is sign a signing statement next to it, which says he doesn't have to abide by this law.
Exactly. And it's amazing to belittle the importance of what it would mean to take a stand in this moment in the face of this statement that Mukasey has made that he's not sure that waterboarding is illegal. He has put that forward. And now there's an opportunity for it. Absolutely unequivocal repudiation of that position. That power is there, and it's just slipping away. It's an amazing moment. It's an amazing crossing of the line into active complicity. It's bad enough that you have Democrats in power who are unwilling to hold the Bush administration legally accountable for the war crimes they've already committed, but now they've moved into endorsement. And they can say all they want that they're not actually voting for him when it comes to torture, but they just did it because he has said it publicly and they no longer have plausible deniability. It's gone.
You've written about torture in Chile and Argentina.
Yeah, and the waterboarding or simulated drowning. And when you read the Truth Commission reports from Chile, Argentina, Guatemala, it's a technique that comes up again and again. Amy, what waterboarding is? It's instilling the belief that you are going to die. We talk about. And people often do die. I mean, it's happened many times. And we talk about torture so often in this country as being just about getting information. Torture is a tool of state terror. That is what torture is, and that is why it's prohibited. It is about instilling, it's a method of instilling terror in an individual, and it's also a method of spreading terror throughout a whole society, saying we are willing to use these techniques. If you cross us, you will be subject to these techniques. So it is the science of terror. It is literally terrorism. You know, if you have somebody in your control and your goal is to convince them that they are going to die, and as they gasp for breath, their lungs are filled with water, what are you if not a terrorist?
It's interesting. We had Stephen Gray on yesterday, the independent journalist from Britain who has done so much to track extraordinary rendition flights, these kidnapping flights. And he said in the end that he wants to apologize for himself and all journalists, that he's always used that term simulated drowning, but that waterboarding is actual drowning because you're filling the torture victim's lungs with water.
Yeah. And I mean, you are approaching death and you believe you are going to die. You have the ultimate fear. And so how does this not fit every definition, both international and domestic, against the prohibition of cruel treatment?
I encourage people to go to our website at democracynow.org the day before yesterday's show, Monday's broadcast, when we interviewed Henri Alleg, who is the French journalist who is covering the Algerian revolution in 1957, taken by French military and subjected to water torture, to waterboarding. This is Democracy Now!, democracynow.org. When we come back, we'll talk to Naomi Klein about another issue she has been addressing, the second part of the title of her book, The Shock Doctrine, The Rise of Disaster Capitalism. Stay with us. Cuba, Pastoral, here on Democracy Now!, democracynow.org, The War and Peace Report. I'm Amy Goodman. Rapture Rescue 911, Disaster Response for the Chosen. That's the title of Naomi Klein's latest article in The Nation. It's about the wildfires that have just ravaged Southern California and the spate of new companies that offer privatized solutions to emergency management, only for those rich enough to afford it. Wildfires in California and now floods in Mexico. Naomi Klein, talk about what you call disaster capitalism and how it's played out in this time of global warming.
Well, disaster capitalism, what I mean by that is the use of disasters to push through very unpopular policies, often involving privatization. The last frontier for the privatization of the state is the privatization of those core state functions. You know, the only thing left that hasn't already been privatized and outsourced is, and this is pre-Bush administration, is the army, is the police, is the fire departments. And these core state functions are really seen as this the last great privatization free-for-all. It's already entered healthcare, it's already entered water, it's already entered electricity, the media. So this is the last frontier. And what we saw during the California firefires was something really extraordinary. I mean, people have gone back to their neighborhoods now, and they have see neighborhoods which have just been destroyed by the fires, but a few houses standing, and are asking questions about why some of those houses were saved. And in some cases, you can't explain it, and it's mysterious. In some cases, it's not mysterious. The reasons why some houses were saved and others were not is because the people who lived in those saved houses pay insurance to the company AIG, and AIG offers privatized fire response.
So, American Insurance Group.
Yeah, exactly. And they have a special service, a sort of VIP concierge service, where they spray the homes of the wealthy in certain select zip codes. These are people who pay around $19,000 a year in insurance premiums. And as part of this special service, they get men in fire trucks with the red hats and the bright red fire trucks. They look, for all intents and purposes, like real firefighters, spraying down their homes with fire retardant. But during the California wildfires, they actually did more than that. They actually put out fires and bragged to the press that they saved houses while the house next to it went up like a candle. So this is what I mean by rapture rescue 911. I mean, it's a bit of a flip statement, but you know, I think many of us have known for many years, and we've talked about the fact that there are more and more people in this country, very close to the Bush administration, inside the Bush administration, who really believe That the end times are coming, and you know they think you know them and Kirk Cameron are you know going to be saved, that the hand of God is going to bring them up to the gated city, and the rest of us are going to burn. And this is you know the fantasy of the rapture, this escape from the inferno down below.